If you're currently applying for automation jobs, there's a good chance you may be asked Selenium related questions. Hey guys, it's the test lead. And today we're diving into possible Selenium interview questions that you might get. I'll give you the question and then a suggested answer. First, Selenium basics. What is Selenium WebDriver and how does it differ from Selenium IDE? Selenium WebDriver is a tool for automating web applications. It provides a programming interface for interacting with web elements and is more powerful than Selenium IDE, which is simply a record and playback tool. Explain the differences between implicit wait and explicit wait. Implicit wait sets a global timeout for the driver to wait for an element. Explicit wait waits for a specific condition to be met before proceeding. When would you use driver.close and driver.quit methods in Selenium? Driver.close closes the current browser window, while driver.quit closes all browser windows and ends the WebDriver session. Use quit to ensure that all the resources are released after testing. How can you handle multiple windows in Selenium WebDriver? Use get windows handles to get all the window handles. Switch between them using switch to window, passing in your handle, and close or interact with specific windows accordingly. Now let's get into locators and find element strategies. Explain the differences between ID, name, class name, and tag name locators in Selenium. These are all different types of locators used to find web elements. ID and name are unique identifiers. Class name and tag name match multiple elements. There could be multiple tags or classes with the same name. What is the XPath locator and when would you prefer it over other locators? XPath is a powerful locator that can traverse the XML structure of an HTML document. It's useful when there are no unique identifiers or for complex traversals. Pair XPath and CSS selectors. What are the pros and cons of each? XPath is more flexible, but may be slower. CSS selectors are faster and have better browser support. XPath allows backward and forward traversals, while CSS selectors are simpler and more readable. Quick break. If you are enjoying this video so far and getting value from it, please leave a like and subscribe. Also, if you need help on your software testing journey, check out my website, thetestinglead.com. Now, back to the video. When would you prefer using a relative XPath over an absolute XPath? Relative XPath is preferred for flexibility and maintenance. It is less likely to break when the structure of the page changes. Absolute XPath should be used when elements have no reliable identifiers. Switching between frames and windows. Explain how to switch between frames and Selenium WebDriver. Use switchTo.frame by providing the frame index, frame name, or ID, or a reference to the frame element to switch to the desired frame. How can you handle frames within frames, also known as nested frames, in Selenium? Use a sequence of switch2.frame commands to navigate through the hierarchy of nested frames. Describe the process of switching between Windows and Selenium. Use get window handles to get the handles of all the open windows. Then use switch2.window passing in the handle to switch to your desired window. Now let's finish with some more advanced Selenium concepts. When testing a page with multiple iframes, what challenges might you encounter and how do you overcome them? Challenges may include identifying the correct iframe and managing switching. Use unique identifiers for iframes and switch to the correct iframe using switch2frame. Discuss the importance of page object model in Selenium automation. POM, or page object model, is a design pattern that enhances test maintenance and readability by encapsulating web page elements and interactions in separate classes. It promotes code reusability and modularity. How do you handle dynamic content or AJAX calls in Selenium automation? Use implicit or explicit weights to handle dynamic content. WebDriver weight combined with expected conditions is effective in handling AJAX calls. You can also incorporate JavaScript. Explain the concept of headless browser testing in Selenium and its advantages. Headless browser testing involves running browser tests without a graphical user interface. It is faster, consumes fewer resources, and is suitable for continuous integration environments. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or suggestions for future videos, please leave them below. Most importantly, don't forget this, learn something new today.